Found Harmonium is one of the sort of real classic Penguin pieces. The way we play it is, it's quite a short version, and we play it quite slowly. But the motif that's in the central bit is, well, it starts off very similar to Perpetuum Mobile, but then the variations and the drones mean that it takes on, well, it's quite a sort of Irish vibe. It's, yeah. So on the harmonium, there's a droning G, but then you have this. So rhythmically, that stays pretty much consistent in its sort of basic form, but then it develops into something. C flat, A flat rather. And that suggests there's a sort of slightly syncopated stab that we do with cowbells and piano and everything, but you get this. Telephone and rubber bands came about when my dad was sat in the studio in 1973, 74 possibly, later. And he was making a phone call and the exchange got mixed, crossed wires with an engaged tone and a ringing tone. And they were in sort of perfect sync, two against three, I think. And he took the, as I understand, it was one of those old Bakelite phones, so he unscrewed the top and got the wires out, put them onto a phono cable, ran that into a tape machine, created a loop. And then the patterns of the two tones suggested a very simple melody, and then played that as suggested bigger melody. And it sort of keeps growing. I mean, the version we play is the end result of 25 years of just keeps on going. Ends up with this sort of dub hoedown thing. But I'll check. So the engaged tone is G, and then you have the ringing tone, which is A, which suggests the string melody. And then later on that goes through various developments because each melody suggests another melody, and it follows through until everything's built up into this dub, sort of, well, hoedown kind of. Giles Farnaby's dream is based on a combination of two elements. The first is Giles Farnaby was a composer in, I think, the 1500s, and he wrote this rather lovely melody, which my dad took and combined with Venezuelan Yoruba sort of quattro rhythms. And they just, for some reason, they sit very well together, and they sort of emphasize elements of each other rather than detracting or blurring things. It's absolutely my favorite piece to play. So the Giles Farnaby melody originally goes... which then leads into a D, G, A pattern, which if you learn Venezuelan quattro, you play it, it's something called a Yoruba. Yoruba is sort of Venezuelan folk music, but then there are various rhythms, but the one we use is rather than the straight 6-8, which you get in Salty Bean, this one has two downstrokes. So. And once you start doing that quite fast, you get these sort of trills, and it moves the feel quite dramatically. Music from the Penguin Cafe is it's a continuation of my understanding of the Penguin Cafe music that my dad wrote. We play a mixture of the old music and new music, which fits well. This first piece we do is Perpetuum Mobile, which is it's one of the original pieces. It's in 15:8, which is because one of the notes has been taken out. It sort of alternates against C, and this leads the ear into the next bit. I'll better show you. The melody is a very simple one, which just goes with the C alternating after every note. And then without the C's, it's once you put them back in, but leaving out the C after the A, which I think is the seventh note, and it gives you a rather flowing effect. And then once you go into the fugue developments, it gives you the whole idea of having such an irregular shape on the bar structure, and then couching that in these sort of very lilting strings, which I'm just using fifths here. It's just very sort of characteristic Penguin Cafe. Salty Bean Fumble is it's a sort of Cajun hoedown piece. Again, the main rhythm behind it is played on a triangle, and so you're sort of creating this circle inside a triangle. And you know, the drummer has to just do this incredibly steadily for quite a long time. I think it's called Salty Bean Fumble because Pythagoras, who was very sort of big in my father's creative life, he hated beans all his life and didn't let his followers eat beans, I think. And then when it came for him to die, it was because he was trying to run across a bean field away from his would-be assassins, but then bean fields are very difficult to navigate, so he got caught. So I don't know why it's called Salty.
Thank you.
So Harry Piers is one of our new ones. I wrote it originally for my dad's memorial service 12 years ago. The way it works is that there are a few simple ideas which I just sort of keep putting on top of each other and then slightly moving sideways, if you see what I mean, on the time frame. And I never wrote a melody for it exactly. It was just, if you, once you start putting these ideas together and just repeating them, then you get these sort of emphatic points on the right side of the keyboard. And then you feed that back in, and then you go round again with this new element stuck in. I think that's quite a... That's something my dad used to do a lot, I think. It's a penguin way of composing, I suppose. Yeah, well,